It's our, one of our favorites that we watch here religiously every Christmas, at least once. And I guess my daughters, I think I've actually tried to get my daughters to watch it too. I'm pretty good at trying to say this one, but they'll get it one day. He loved serving his customers down at Charlie's, and many became lifelong friends to him. He made sure no one left hungry, even if they didn't have money to pay the bill that day. He was a fan of magic. I forgot about that, but he found some magic tricks that he had that he used to try out on his customers and his grandkids. Love his daddy, corny dad jokes, which I think my family would agree I inherited it. One of his favorite things was going up the road, which was in our house, meant heading to the casino. During his working years, my mother and him spent many nights up in Atlantic City. And then Delaware Park after he retired. I'd like to thank his good buddy, Paul, who was originally a customer. And then became a real good friend of my dad and my brother-in-law Ray, who helped him get up the road a couple more times over his last few weeks. Our father was a good man, he was a hard-working man, he was a simple man really, he was a father, a grandfather, a great-grandfather. He was a brother, a brother-in-law, a godfather, an uncle, a business owner, and a friend to so many. Most importantly, he was a loving husband to our mother for 59 years. It was truly amazing. They were just kids themselves when they started this family, and you could say they beat the odds and managed to raise three kids and stay together through all the life throughout them. We were truly blessed to have such great role models. It wasn't until we became adults and had families of our own that we realized how difficult it must have been and the sacrifices they made to provide us a great childhood. I never remember feeling that we did without. Our father worked endless hours in the restaurant, leaving my mom to take care of all the family stuff while still putting time into Charlie's. I can remember coming home from Little League games and having to go down to the restaurant to tell him how the games went. He'd still be down there preparing for the next day. It's a little more difficult here. We found a letter he had written just recently. My sister found it. He wrote it late one night in 2015 after he received his first cancer diagnosis. And we thought it was worth sharing with you today. 12:05 on April 26, 2015, and I can't sleep. I'm trying to watch TV, but all I can think about is my life. 4 days ago, the doctor called with some bad news. I guess I'm just feeling sorry for myself. Then a St. Jude's commercial came on with all those babies and kids fighting for their lives and crying like a baby. Here I am, 17 years on this earth, a great mom and dad who worked so hard, a great childhood, a great family, a big sister, a big brother, a little brother, and a little sister. My mom's kids were everything to her. Then still in my teens, I met and fell in love with Carol. We got married and had our first baby, Carrie. Then Tommy, and then perfected it with Tracy. I may have added a word. Your mom. another letter. It was really just a thank you letter to their neighbors, Brian and Stephanie. They did something very nice for them. He wanted to make sure that how much they knew how much it meant to them. But he talked a little bit about my mom in this letter, and he had some nice words at the end, so I wanted to share some of that with you. They had surprised my mom by removing an old dead tree that sat outside their kitchen window, and my mom was upset about it because she felt like her grandfather may have planted it at some point. It meant a lot to her. So one day while they were out, Brian and Stephanie, and I guess maybe their boys, went over and removed the tree and cleaned everything up like it was never there. And then another day while they were out, they planted a new tree, and my father thanked them for that, and it meant so much to them. He talked about how sentimental she was about things, that she loved that she lived in her old house that her grandfather had built, and how she loved that her brother lived next door to her in the house that their father had built. How something so trivial to most, such as an old tree or bush dying in her yard, was upsetting to her because it was planted by her grandfather or given to them by a since passed family friend. How if she would have won Powerball, she would have never left her little house in Rosedale. He ended the letter with these words, and I felt it was good words to end this eulogy with. He said, "My wife is a special person. Family is everything. Little things mean a lot. And a kind word or card can help. Love, Tom." I just want to thank all our family, friends, and neighbors who helped us get through difficult time. A special thanks to his sister Aunt Diane and his brother Uncle Charles for spending time with him, provide him some company, and my sister a much needed break. My sister Carrie, who put her life on hold the last 6 months to care for my mom and then my father. I'd be remiss not to mention his good friend Joe, who originally also was a customer but later became one of my father's best friends. He'd since moved to Florida, but he immediately came up when my mom passed to spend time with my father for several weeks. And then when I called him to tell him that things were not looking good, he immediately jumped in his truck and drove up from Florida. Once again, spent time with him, and he provided him with friendship and comfort every day over the last 5 weeks. Thank you, and God bless everyone.
Yeah.